Last week, the Constitutional Court in Kampala now filed the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Control Act of 2015. This led to jubilations by some of the advocates and dealers of narcotics, who included a team from Wakiso Mirror Growers and Dealers Association Limited, who filed a suit challenging the law in 2017. However, the ruling by the Constitutional Court attracted mixed reactions from MPs who vowed to return the legislation, saying such a ruling is likely to exacerbate drug abuse in Uganda.
The application of the act, an anti-narcotic act, it's unfortunate. But as a parliament, we don't get tired. We are very ready to bring the back the bill, and we consider it. We are going to mobilize heavily all members of parliament to be with us so that we can pass a bill, because the challenge of the court is not something which is, it's not a very big deal. It's all about quorum. Which quorum we have the capability, all the 525 members of parliament will be here, and we vote overwhelmingly.
If government does not move fast, we can move as private members and have this law retabled.
During the weekly security briefing today, police vowed to continue enforcing operations against narcotics use, sale and storage, this time round relying on the National Drugs Authority Act of 1993. Iranga explains that the use of narcotic drugs and psychotropic substances is very disastrous, not only to individual consumers, but also to society.
Our policy is to continue tackling narcotics-related offences in the National Drug Policy and Authority Act 1993. So although the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act 2015 was nullified for lack of quorum on the part of Parliament by the Constitutional Court, we want to inform the public that fortunately the old law of the National Drug Authority was not affected.
Police indicate that the use of narcotics drugs increased in the year 2022 with children among perpetrators, which continues to worry authorities.
Out of the crime statistics of 2022, a total of 4,818 suspects were arrested and charged to court, including 137 juveniles. And out of that, cannabis has consistently been the most used drug, or marijuana, and then followed by cocaine and other soft drugs.
So in April 2015, President Museveni signed the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substance Control Act into law. This criminalized the possession of narcotic drugs and psychotropic substances, where any person found in possession of any narcotic drug or substance commits an offense and is liable on conviction to a fine of not less than 500 currency points or 3 times the market value of the drug, whichever is greater, or to imprisonment of not less than 10 years but not exceeding 25 years or both. Also, police cracked down on a gang of criminals who were engaged in car theft. The group, according to police, would steal vehicles from the city and drive them to Iganga, where the number plates were swapped to disguise them.
9 members have been arrested and 10 suspected stolen motor vehicles recovered in an operation that began from Kajansi and was expanded up to Iganga.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.